It is time to talk some NFL offseason. What is going on, y'all? Five Sports Talk back at it with another video talk. And of course, some NFL here to talk about NFL free agency and who I believe the Chicago Bears should target in this year's NFL free agency, because we all know the goal is, of course, to get another step closer to winning a Super Bowl. And the Bears last year had a heartbreaking loss. I don't want to get into all that. With that being said, I'll give you guys three players that the Bears should target in this coming offseason, or I should say this offseason, because we're officially at that point. But come free agency, who should the Bears look at and how they should improve this roster and why they should go after certain players? Before I get into that, if you're new to the channel, what are you doing? Make sure to hit that subscribe button down below and follow me on my social media links down below, my Twitter, my Instagram, all of that good stuff down there. With that being said, I'll get, like I said, give you guys three players the Bears should target in this year's free agency. So with that being said, let's get started. At number three, I will start with tight end Tyler Eifert. Now, I know what you guys are thinking, Fives. He's injury prone. He gets hurt every single season. Last year, we know he broke his ankle in a gruesome injury, and he's had back issues and everything else in between. Cool, I got it, okay? Here's the point. We're not making a huge investment in him if we do sign him. The reason I want the Bears to go after Tyler Eifert is because even though we addressed tight end this past season with Trey Burton, who was our starting tight end, I believe he had a disappointing season from what I expected. And really, with Trey Burton, I was expecting more of an impact, and I didn't believe he brought that in to it. He didn't become a de facto tight end one like I thought he would. He's more of a tight end two. So bring in some competition and let's get and take a chance on a guy like a Tyler Eifert, who's still just 28 years old. I know it feels like he's been in the league forever, but just 28. He's 6'6". Trey Burton's about 6'3", okay? So that size will really help Mitch in the red zone. And boy, could you imagine what Matt Nagy would be able to do with a guy like a Tyler Eifert. And last year, signed with the Bengals for a one-year $5.5 million deal. I believe we can get him on a bargain, okay? So you get him in here. We just released Deion Sims, so we could use tight end depth. And I'm not even saying him as a starter. Trey Burton could still be the starter, but let's get him in as a rotational piece even and just get some competition at the position. I know we still have Adam Shaheen, our young tight end, but he's still not developed yet. So for me, I don't mind taking a flyer on a chance like a Tyler Eifert, okay? Tight end was one of those positions where it was a come and go for us. It wasn't super consistent all year long. So why not take a chance on a guy like that? I'm all in. Let's take a shot on Tyler Eifert. At number two, running back Tevin Coleman. Yes, Tevin Coleman of the Atlanta Falcons, who is a free agent this offseason. I don't believe he will be re-signing with the Falcons, and I don't believe the Falcons will want him back, okay? So why do I like him on the Bears? Because he's a shifty back with incredible speed and power as well. And for the system that Matt Nagy has, I believe he's a much better fit than Jordan Howard. Now, I know a lot of Bears fans this offseason and at the end of last season were clamoring for the Bears to trade Jordan Howard or get rid of him. Look, I'm not a hater of Jordan Howard. I like Jordan Howard, actually. I think he's fine in this offense, but could we upgrade the position? Absolutely. We know in Matt Nagy's system, speed and dynamic backs like Tariq Cohen excel, okay? Because he can get those guys out on the wheel route. We know Tevin Coleman can catch and run the football. So for just a schematic fit, Tevin Coleman would be a better fit than a Jordan Howard, who's more of a power bruising running back. So this is contingent on a few things. One, the Bears do not have Jordan Howard on the roster, which means we end up trading him or somewhat of releasing him, but I don't think we should do that. But the Bears trade him, and then we bring in Tevin Coleman. I believe if we add Tevin Coleman and still have Jordan Howard and Tariq Cohen, that might make too much of a committee. And sometimes, you know, a committee isn't always the answer, because some got certain guys won't know their role, what time they're going to play, when they're not. And a lot of times, this past season, Jordan Howard wasn't able to get going because, he didn't really know when he was going to come in the offense. Some games we'd use him, some games we wouldn't. So, point being is, if we still have Jordan Howard on the roster, I don't want to go after Tevin Coleman. But if we decide to move on from Jordan Howard, then I want the Bears to go after Tevin Coleman, who I believe could be had for not too much. I'm looking at somewhere between 4 years and $20 million for Tevin Coleman. I think that's very reasonable, and I certainly think he can be an RB1, and I certainly think he would be a better fit in Matt Nagy's system than Jordan Howard. And at number one, if you don't know where I'm going with this, you should by now, kicker Matt Bryant. The Bears know, and especially Bears fans know, our weakest position all season last year was the kicker position. And to me, I don't want to mess it up this time. I don't care, what it takes. We need to get this position right, okay? And to me, I will take Matt Bryant. I'd rather the Bears go after him than some inexperienced first-year guy or a rookie that we draft in the NFL draft. Let's take an experienced guy like a Matt Bryant, who's a Pro Bowl kicker. And we know he's been consistent, okay? So Matt Bryant, you can go look at the percentages, 80-plus percent, both inside and out, in weather conditions as well. And he's got a big, big leg, so we know that. And the Falcons, obviously, I think just let him go for financial reasons. But we took a hit with letting Cody Parkey go in terms of our finances. Certainly, we didn't take a hit with him going, okay? He needed to go. But we took a hit with the finances. So if the Bears are already ready to pay Cody Parkey to not play for them, let's invest a little bit more money to get the position right, even if Matt Bryant costs a little bit more. But to me, as of right now, looking at all of the available kickers, Matt Bryant, to me, is the best option available. I want the Bears to go after him. I believe, and it's funny, when you think about it, the Bears' number one priority being kicker, I believe he should be our number one priority this offseason, okay? Because the rest of the roster, pretty solid. Yes, we could use improvements, but certainly nothing that needs to improve more than the kicker position. So let's go after Matt Bryant. Let's make it happen. That doesn't mean we can't get more competition in the building. Robbie Gould is off the books, folks, because the 49ers are going to franchise tag him. So I don't want anybody in the comments talking about, let's go after Robbie Gould, okay, because that's probably not going to happen. So unless another free agent kicker, a top-level kicker, becomes free on the market, let's go after Matt Bryant. That's just what I think. So there you have it, folks. Three free agents that I believe the Bears should go after this NFL offseason. Let me know if you guys agree or disagree. Leave a comment down below. And as always, thanks for watching.